Every day we're learning more about our living and life-giving soil and how dependent we are upon it. In the past, little thought was given to the vast kingdom of microbes below ground. However, we now realize without healthy life below ground, there'd be little life above it. Not so long ago, it was thought that the best hope for our soil was to slow its loss by using conservation practices to reduce wind and water erosion. But farmers and scientists have discovered that we can actually build better functioning, higher performing, and more productive soils. In fact, healthy soils rich in organic matter and microbial life may well be the key to feeding the world's growing population sustainably well into the future. And by farming in ways that protect and enhance soil microbes and improve soil health, farmers and ranchers are breathing new life into our soils. This video series will show you how they're doing it and what that means for all of us. There is an amazing, hidden, living kingdom beneath our feet. In fact, millions of species and billions upon billions of organisms, bacteria, algae, microscopic insects, earthworms, beetles, nematodes, ants, mites, fungi, and more reside in the soil. This life represents the greatest concentration of biomass anywhere on the planet. While scientists work to more fully understand this complex and elegant ecosystem, many producers already know that when they farm in ways that protect and enhance the soil's microbial communities, good things happen. They understand that microbes build better soils and help make farms more profitable and resilient to weather extremes. Plus, producers who farm with soil-building practices use less energy, improve water quality, and create better wildlife habitat. These soil health farmers disturb the soil as little as possible, keep the soil covered with plants or plant residues, keep living roots in the soil as much of the year as possible, and use diverse species. There are four primary conservation activities that enable farmers to achieve these principles on their farms: planting without tilling, growing cover crops, rotating diverse crops, and grazing diverse plants. When used in systems over time, the benefits of these soil health practices can be substantial, both on and off the farm, which is good for the farm, the farmer, and all of us. So how exactly do these farmers plant without plowing? Most use no-till planters, which are designed to slice through plant residues from previous harvests while minimizing soil disturbance as they plant the seeds for their crops. Here's how it works. Pulled by a tractor, a no-till planter uses thin rotating discs to make a narrow slice through the plant residue and into the soil. Next, a tube places the seed at an appropriate depth in the soil, while a second wheel gently presses or firms the seed into the soil to ensure proper seed-to-soil contact. Once the seed is placed and covered, presto! We're ready to grow, with very little disturbance to the soil or to the organisms that reside there. And here are some of the other benefits of no-till. Farmers reduce labor, fuel, and machinery costs, and they also improve how well soils function. Fewer tillage passes prevent compaction and surface crusting of soil, making it easier for plants to sprout and grow deep roots. No-till farming reduces erosion by leaving plant residue on the soil surface, which protects the soil from the damaging impacts of raindrops and the wind. Since there is no plowing with no-till, much less airborne dust is created, which helps everyone breathe easier. Crop residue left on the soil surface from no-till also limits evaporation, conserving water for plant growth. That crop residue is also a source of carbon, the essential energy source for living organisms that make up the soil food web. No-tilled fields often have more beneficial insects and earthworms and a larger, better balanced microbial community that can even resist disease outbreaks. Those organisms increase the soil's organic matter content and build soil structure. Aggregates are like a house with walls and rooms. It's a city down there. Soil in no-till systems with better rooms or pores absorbs and stores more water, and plants are able to grow their roots deeper into the soil to get to that water. This means that farmers can prevent floods and grow crops that survive droughts. We all know what crops are, but do you know what a cover crop is? Simply put, a cover crop is planted to keep cropland covered between the time a cash crop is harvested and the next one is planted. Cover crops aren't usually harvested. They're planted to improve soil health, to feed those many beneficial organisms in the soil that make nutrients available for the next cash crop a farmer will grow to harvest and sell. Cover crops are also known as green manures, which feed the soil's microorganisms. Those microorganisms, in turn, make nutrients available for the next cash crop harvest. Since cover crops aren't usually harvested, they don't have to grow to maturity. Typically, they grow during the late summer and fall, before the onset of winter, or in the early spring before the cash crop is planted. After cover crops grow, many naturally die in the winter. But some are terminated by herbicide or by mechanical means like a roller crimper. Right before the next cash crop is planted and grown. Farmers throughout the nation are planting cover crops after harvesting their cash crops to benefit the soil and their farming operations. Cover crops play a key role in soil health management systems and have many on- and off-farm benefits. When a tilled field doesn't have growing plants in it, the surface structure of the soil is damaged by the impact of raindrops so that it can seal. When that happens, much of the water will run off into streams and lakes instead of infiltrating into the soil. Cover crops protect the soil surface and can help eliminate that sealing effect. Water infiltrates better through these continuous pores that roots create. Roots also improve soil tilth, or structure, by growing through layers of soil that are hard and compacted. By breaking up these layers, cover crops make it easier for cash crop roots to grow deeper. Beneficial organisms in the soil, such as earthworms and microscopic bacteria, protozoa, and others, thrive when they have plenty of cover crop plant material to eat. As they decompose this material, soil organic matter levels and aggregation, or structure, improve, which further improves the health and function of the soil. Did you know that there are more microorganisms in a handful of healthy soil than there are people on the planet? Cover crops reduce wind and water erosion. By having the soil stuck together into strong aggregates and held in place by cover crops during the fall, winter, and early spring, loss of soil from erosion can be reduced or eliminated, which also helps reduce nutrient runoff into rivers, lakes, and oceans. Legume-type cover crops can add substantial amounts of available nitrogen to the soil. They collaborate with symbiotic bacteria called rhizobia to fix nitrogen from the air and turn it into a form that plants can use. Some legume cover crops, like peas, alfalfa, and clovers, usually fix more than 50 pounds of nitrogen per acre, and even 300 pounds is possible. Non-legumes cover crops can take up excess nitrogen and other nutrients applied for previous crops and recycle them to make them available for the following crop. Cover crops provide habitat for beneficial insects, such as lady beetles and pollinators. And those pollinators are important because worldwide, approximately 1,000 plants grown for food, beverages, fibers, spices, and medicines need to be pollinated by animals in order to produce the resources upon which we depend. Cover crops and their plant residues help keep the soil cooler in the heat of summer, which improves plant health. The soil temperature of tilled or plowed soil can be 20 degrees hotter than the soil protected by cover crops. Surface residue also reduces evaporation in the heat of summer. In the long term, building healthier soils and maintaining cover makes farms more resilient to drought. Living roots in the soil throughout the year create root channels and feed microorganisms. Roots and organisms together produce biotic glues and build the porous soil structure, or aggregates. Those tiny organisms are so important that plants exude substances through their roots to attract them to live in their root zones. A dense stand of winter rye or other cover crop can suppress weeds by keeping them in the dark, unable to get the sunlight they need to grow. Some cover crops even produce natural chemicals that can further suppress the growth of weeds. Rather than planting one or two crops year after year on the same fields, soil health farmers use cropping rotations, featuring a diversity of crops, cover crops, and forages for grazing animals over multiple years to build healthier soils. Crop rotations have been used for centuries to improve plant nutrition and to control the spread of pests and disease. here are just some of the benefits of mixing it up. Diverse rotations improve plant nutrition. Legume-type crops, for example, contribute nitrogen to the soil, which the next crop can use. Some crops are better at releasing certain nutrients, like potassium, from soil mineral particles, which will become available to the next crop, too. Some roots bring up nutrients from deep down in the soil so that crops with shallower roots can use them as well. Mixing it up also deters pests and diseases in various ways. For example, growing a crop in only 1 out of 4 years deprives pests from their specific food source for multiple years, so their populations can't grow and take over. Scientists are discovering that diverse plant roots create habitat and food for soil organisms that compete for space with pathogens, so diseases can't take over. Many of these beneficial organisms are also predators of disease-causing organisms. Other organisms simply cover the plant root, creating a barrier so that pathogens can't get to the root. The more we mix it up with diversity, the more we can enrich the soil with bacteria, fungi, yeasts, algae, and protozoa, all of which help plants acquire nutrients, regulate growth, and resist pests and diseases. On the farm, healthy soil provides many benefits. But that's only part of the story. Here are just a few of the off-farm benefits we also get from healthy soil. Much of the precipitation that falls on unhealthy soil runs off, carrying with it sediment, nutrients, and pesticides that can harm rivers, lakes, and oceans. But by improving soil health, we can also improve water quality. There is no plowing with no-tilled and continuously covered cropping systems, so much less airborne dust is created, which helps everyone breathe easier. Soil health farmers also use far less fuel compared to conventional tillage operations, which saves energy and reduces greenhouse gas emissions. And healthy soil makes farms more resilient to weather extremes, which allows farmers to provide a stable food supply to help feed us all. Without a doubt, healthy soils have a lot to offer us. That's why we're working with farmers, ranchers, researchers, and others to harvest this new hope in healthy soil. To learn more, visit nrcs.usda.gov.